Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how to set ringtones on your iPhone on a per contact basis. So the normal way that you would set a ringtone or text tone on your iPhone is to go into the Settings app and under Settings go down to Sounds. This is using iOS 9. And under Sounds, here's where you can set the ringtone and text tone. You can see them here just a little bit down on that screen. So you've got ringtone, text tone, and you've got tones that you could use for other things like new voicemail, new mail, when a mail is sent, things like that. So you've got lots of different things that you could set. But let's focus on ringtones and text tones. If I were to tap on ringtone, I would get a list of ringtones, the standard ringtones that come with your iPhone. And also alert tones. I can choose either one. If I had purchased any custom tones or used iTunes to load any custom ringtones on here, I would see them listed here as well. I could also set the vibration pattern there. Now if I go to text tone, I see the same thing, except that it's going to show alert tones first, and it's also going to give me the option to have none there at the top of the alert tones, and then I get a ringtones second. So it's kind of giving you priority on those two, but you can choose from any one of those. Now those are actually the default ringtones. So that's going to be used for all of your contacts when they either call you or message you. But you can set a custom one per contact. So let's go into the Contacts app. And here I've already gone into a fake person here that I've created for this demo. But of course you would see the list of all your contacts and you would select one to go into them. Now here we've got John Smith, and there's a home phone number and an iPhone number too. And the home phone number, of course, is just voice only. The iPhone is voice and messaging. Now you don't see anything here for setting custom ringtones. In order to see that, you need to tap the Edit button at the upper right. When you do that, you could, of course, add phones. You can add emails, and those emails can include Apple ID emails that would then be used for iMessages. So you can message somebody through a phone number or through an email address. And then you see ringtone and vibration and text tone and vibration. So say if I wanted to set a custom ringtone. Right now it's set to default, which means it's going to follow the settings under sounds that we just looked at. But if I tap there, I can actually choose a custom ringtone for that person. And I'll hear that ringtone rather than the default one. So the key thing is, like, say you want to have your significant other have another ringtone, you can just set it here and just don't use that ringtone for anybody else. Likewise, I said cancel, we can go to text tone and we can set a custom text tone. So if we wanted to set something custom there and we'd hear it played as a sample and hit done, and we could see now that it's set there as a custom text tone. And likewise, you can do the same thing with vibrations. You can use the standard different vibrations, or you can set up custom ones and set that instead of the default for that person. So you'll get a different ringtone or a different vibration or both, depending upon how you have things set up for that person. This could be very useful so you know who's calling you without even taking your iPhone out of your pocket or bag. Now I actually rarely use ringtones. I keep my phone on silent. I'd rather have vibrations tell me when somebody's calling or when I get a text message. And it's easy under vibration to select one of these different vibration patterns or add your own. You see I have a bunch of custom ones I've added there. And you can easily create your own by hitting create new vibration. And then you tap to create a vibration pattern. So it could be anything. You can just create a different vibration pattern for just about every contact you've got and grow to know them so that you can tell who's calling you or who just texted you. It's very useful, especially if you don't want to be pulling out your phone every time you get a text message, but you do want to pay attention when a certain person texts you.